It's the Bob Doyle Show. I'm excited. Are you?
It's the Bob Doyle Show.
That's right. Imitations. Hey. Hi.
It's the Bob Doyle Show.
It's the Bob Doyle Show.
It's the Bob Doyle Show.
It's the Bob Doyle Show. Is everybody at home doing the same thing that I am? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Bob Doyle Show. It's the weekly extravaganza that we perform for you. That's right, this is a performance. This is a performance that is being performed at you, with you, for you, beside you, and with you. Did I already say with you? If I did, many apologies. Folks, you've tuned into the Bob Doyle Show, episode 39. My big fad body's in the way. That's not true. It's not in the way, nor is it big and fat. So, I've just started the show with a bunch of nonsense. Now look, we're going to have to make a deal today. Here's the deal. Now, first of all, let's just take care of the technicalities right off the bat, right? I got to bring up the page on my, today, by the way, is a very behind the scenes kind of thing. If you'd like to look, we're going to truly lift the veil. We're going to lift the veil. So we're going to lift it and then you'll be able to see behind it. This is a very behind the scenes type of show. Now, we're already pretty transparent, aren't we? Can we agree? Can't see your comments yet because I haven't loaded the page. So that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to go to the Bob Doyle Show fan page, which this is where you should be, ladies and gentlemen, if you're watching this show, if you're consuming it as they were, that's not how you say that. All right, now I'm turning down the volume, and then Deborah Lee is here. Let's see if your comments are showing correctly. Nope, not yet. That's right, I have to do that. Well, hey, no, there was no need to start the whole show all over. I'd forgotten my sequence of events, but this is the good news. I've got it all figured out. Deborah Lee Merchant is first in the house, so she wins the first in the house prize if we had one. Oh, when are those sponsors going to step up? Now, this is what happened last time. It spun and spun as if it wasn't doing it, but we're going to test it right now. Yeah, there she is. Deborah Lee and Loretta Parks are both here. Let's welcome them with a big round of applause because they were on time. Not only are they here, but they were here in the first 2 minutes of the show. And you know, honestly, the official policy, 5 minutes, you're on time. Can you believe that? How flexible am I? Now, so hold on. I haven't even had a sip of coffee out of my Bob Doyle Show coffee mug yet. So it's really like the show hasn't even started. It's more like I'm running late by 3 minutes. That is what I am talking about. You know, I was thinking, you know, when the show gets really highfalutin, when there's actually a desk here and I'm actually in front of a city, I don't know. A coffee machine, like right here, would be awesome, wouldn't it? Can you imagine if I had full access to shots of coffee throughout the broadcast? Like, oh sure, you know, I run out of this probably around minute 30. Maybe more if I'm really chatty. But then what? So if I could just, you know, right here, what harm could that do? What could possibly go wrong? Am I right? Am I right? Am I right? Here's the deal we have to make. Now, seriously, this is serious. Wait a minute. First of all, what's going on? I see two of you here. It is Friday, I believe. I forgot to send out the notification. I'm going to do it right now. That's right. Now, I told you already that this is a very behind-the-scenes show, and particularly today. You wait. Your mind's going to be blown. But right now, I got to get this response out because there's people who are going, is there a show? I don't know. If my thing doesn't show up, how can I possibly know? Yeah, oops is right, Deborah Lee. Oops is right. Amen, sister. Amen. All right, hold on. I'm just doing this. I'm using a service, by the way, called Push Response. Oh, but here's the really unfortunate part. I have to type something. I'm gonna, you know what? How transparent is this? I'm going to show you the whole thing. That's right. We're going to start off the show by giving you a little tutorial on this service, which is taking its sweet time bringing up. Now, here's what I do every... Now, look at this. This is free, ladies and gentlemen. I am not charging you anything extra for this. This is just free. Free. And that's why this is reason number 7. Why this is the most talked about show you're not watching. Not you, but you know how they do that. Everybody else. Like when this is on the cover of Entertainment Weekly or whatever, you know. The best podcast you're not watching. That kind of thing. You've seen it. Anyway, so I go here and I have to say episode 39, and it's called Zombies. Really? Seriously, we're going to get to this. I am not all talk on this one. And now I'm going to write a little thing here that says, you can't see because my body's in the way. If you stay awake thinking about zombies, get in here now. All right, that's it. I'm not going to make any more whatever. I'm clicking update, so that will save. And then I'm going to click this magic send button. In just a second, I'm going to go back over here to the notification in question, which this one is about this particular show, and I'm going to click on send, and it's going to ask for right now or schedule. Well, I should have scheduled it before, but I didn't, so it's an instant broadcast. Boom. Now people are getting notified. People are now getting notified about this show. Thank you very much. Now the floodgates should just, whatever floodgates do. But seriously, do I really have to depend on these live notifications? All of you who aren't watching this live, you are going to really kick yourself later. So I'm sending out the vibe now for all of you who forgot, who thought that for some reason there was something more important to do today. I don't know what was going on in your brain. But not today. Not today. We've got way too much going on. First of all, we do have Deborah Lee and Loretta in the house, at least. But that's it. Where is everyone? Literally everyone. Everyone else. Those of you, is it because I did a live-ish show last week? One pre-recorded show, and that just destroys the whole magic, the whole allure? Now you're like, I don't know. Is he live? I don't know. I can't risk that. I need to know he's going to be live. He can't be doing that stuff. That's it. I'm never listening again. There's Dawn. Oh, she was on a call. So that explains Dawn. But what about everybody else? I don't know, Rob Hicks, when you finally start watching this today, broadcasting on my, you know what I got to do? And it's what all of us have to do. You know what I'm going to say. That's right. We have to share this broadcast. We have to. We have to. There's only 3 of us in here, and we've got a creative thing to do today. It's really creative, and we need input from all sources, not just 3 people. Seriously, we're going to do something today that is unprecedented on live streaming. I can almost promise you that you have never seen what we're going to do, nor has anyone ever done it, ever in the history of Facebook Live. I wager to say that the odds are highly in my favor on this statement that I'm making to you. We are calling in the troops, ladies and gentlemen. There's Jeff Adams, folks. Jeff Adams, ladies and gentlemen. Why not? Why not? Why not? Okay, we've got Dawn is calling in Tina and Amanda and Vicky. And Jeff called in someone named Hey Hey. So I hope Hey Hey shows up because, man, they sound like fun, don't they? Am I right? Am I right? Am I right? So anyway, as I was saying, today's going to... So this is the deal we have to make. I've been trying to tell you this, except that you weren't here to hear it. The deal is, you have to promise. You have to make a pact with me if you're going to watch today's show. That you will not hold me personally responsible on any level if you go out of your freaking mind because this is more fun than you've ever had ever in your life. Okay? I'm just saying, this isn't... We just have to make this agreement. And that and this and what I'm talking about isn't even the zombie thing. That's right. Oh, wait, I didn't share. I didn't finish. Here I talked about, and I had this wave of, you know how when you feel incomplete? You know what I'm talking about, don't you? You know who I'm talking to, don't you? That's right, you. That whole thing. I was going to do something. And it just all day. And that when, luckily, mine was easy enough, sharing my own broadcast. So I'm going to the page right now because I can't do it on my iPod thingy. Pad? iPod? I was about to say I never owned an iPod. That would have been a lie because I did, in fact, own one. Okay, page. Hello, internet. I'm waiting for my page to load. You guys just continue to talk amongst yourself. You know, when Scott gets here and Brian K. Wright, he needs to do his, that's right, he needs to come to every single one of these shows to do his show research, as I will be a guest on his show, I believe, that's 12th of December of this year. That's right. Normally, the Brian K. Wright waiting list goes years. Years. No. Not Bob Doyle of the Bob Doyle Show, who was rumored to play some role in the film The Secret, if you've ever heard of that. All right, I'm now sharing my broadcast. I could show you this, but, you know, you all know what it looks like because you're doing it on your own timelines, right? Okay. Hey, where are you? We're all just sitting around waiting for you. Post. There. Now that it's shared on my timeline, we should lose viewers. Okay, that's not true. Anyway, nobody chimed in on the idea of the coffee maker sitting right beside me. Would that be a good idea? I think so. Let me put it this way. It would be an idea. Why Bob Doyle and not Bobby Doyle or Robert Doyle? Well, a million reasons. The first of which is I would hate either one of those names for a show. It's the Robert Doyle Show. Hello, I'm Robert Doyle. Today I'll be dispensing tax advice in the most boring, monotonous tone you can imagine. In fact, I know nothing about tax advice, but I'm going to continue to drone on and on about it because my name is Robert Doyle. If you want entertainment, you should check out my brother's podcast called The Bob Doyle Show. He's got fun mugs and shirts and everything. But on the Robert Doyle Show, well, you get the idea. Now, look, I'm not trying to say that Robert Hicks is boring. I'm totally not. That was for my own amusement and possibly that of Jeff Adams. All right. So before we get started on this zombie thing, I think the perfect lead-in for this is just something I was thinking about yesterday. Sometimes I think about things. That's when all the trouble starts. And don't ask me why. Somehow, Madonna's Get Into the Groove song got in my head. Look, trust me, it's not playing around the house. And look, if you're a fan of Madonna's Get Into the Groove, okay. But look, here's the deal. What really stuck out in my mind, and I think this just speaks to my age and experience in life. But basically, it's just these lines. Get into the groove. Forget that one. We can throw that one away. The next one's the only one that really matters. Boy, you've got to prove your love to me. Yeah. Those are the actual lyrics. Boy, you've got to prove your love to me. Folks, can I just say that if you're in a situation, a relationship situation, where you have to prove your love, I'm guessing it's time to move on. Because you've either screwed up and you're just not, why, prove it? Really? Prove your love to me? Nope. I'm going to say that if that conversation ever takes place, this is not a soulmate situation we're working on. If you tell someone they've got to prove their love to you, then that means they either screwed up or you're massively insecure. Neither one of those is probably the recipe for a good thing, because if you are making him prove his love because he did screw up, or she, it could be the other way around, or same, whatever. It's the 2000s. Where's that shovel? You know, If you say, you've got to prove this to me, well, then that's going to be your whole life. Truly. Because then if you do it, you're always the one who proved, who did the thing. And she's, or he, whoever said that, always going to be. And it's not going to be an equal relationship. So basically what I'm saying is, I just don't think that song had a very good grasp on long-term relationships. I think that's it. Now that Melanie Benson is here, we can begin with the zombie conversation, because I know that she is an aficionado, and in fact, she's here to be our special guest expert, but unfortunately, our lines are down. That used to be a thing that people would say. Our lines are down, so we can't do that thing. Anyway, Dawn is calling out everybody she knows to be here. Yeah, been going through a divorce because of that damn song. Well, you know, it's a wake-up call, ladies and gentlemen. Neither party should be... Look, don't get me started on relationships. We're here to talk about zombies. But not before one other thing. 7 people? What? I've always said this isn't important. But what's going on here? What... Don't people... Are there no psychics in the world going out and saying, this is the show you don't want to miss? On a grand scale? Aren't you ready for the Bob Doyle show in your life after in this political environment? Don't you need this sort of it's like... You know what it is? It's like a shower. The Bob Doyle show is like a shower that you take to cleanse off the yuck of your day, week, month, year. And possibly life. And that's a sad story, but thank God you found us. On with the talk of zombies. Fine. All right, so in that case, just for the... Oh, that's right, this one, that version of it didn't have the zombie on it. Well, there's a version of this picture with the zombie on it. A zombie version of me. How clever. Guess what? I'm not here to interview a zombie. I'm not here to, because I'll bet you a lot of people thought, oh, Bob in his interviews, he's probably going to talk to a zombie. Nope. I'm not. I just have a few questions. You, Deborah Lee, now look. I'm using this amazing software called Wirecast from a terrific company called Telestream. And they're... Affiliate manager can't stay for my show. All right, she said she'll share later. Ladies and gentlemen, Charlotte Squire, if you can read, said that she shared on her page. And here she is now, ladies and gentlemen, holding the Bob Doyle Show coffee mug, which looks an awful lot like the one I'm holding right here. Pretty exclusive club. There are people, I think that, look, I haven't paid a lot of attention to the zombie thing. Thank you for the thumbs up. Somebody finally chiming in with some likes. Or I just missed them, but I don't think I did. My peripheral vision's pretty good. And Dawn, your friends aren't listening to you. What? I thought you had a little more pull. Well, we'll talk about that later. No, we won't. Okay, so, but look... This whole zombie thing, look, Night of the Living Dead, cute idea, zombies, they die, they come back, they eat your brains. Now it's this whole thing where there's people who actually believe that a zombie apocalypse is possible. These people are out there. They're writing books. They're proving their theories. So can I just ask a couple of questions? Because look, you know what? I'll tell you this. I'm a pretty forward thinker. I have a very, very open mind. I do. People who know me, Lily's here. Let's all just smile together. Okay. But so I could even go as far as to say that there might be some sort of energetic event or nuclear radio, whatever. Name your scenario, whatever does it. And look, if you're a zombie expert, see, Jeff Adams says they're real, they're as Bigfoot. This is probably not a time to not be showing your comments. But I lost the screen again, but this happened yesterday. Or our last week. But we'll get it. See? See how I didn't panic? Didn't break a sweat. Anyway, people who believe in the zombie thing. So, oh, yeah, so if some event, maybe it would reanimate dead bodies. Maybe that's possible. Maybe some sort of something or other, and dead bodies somehow reanimate and move around or something. But wait a second. What is all this brain-eating nonsense? Let's back up. What's all this eating nonsense? If you're a dead person, and you've been dead for some time, chances are, is this too graphic? Chances are, a lot of your eating paraphernalia is gone. Yeah. Certainly not in need of nourishment in the traditional sense. The whole blood flow, nutrients, that's not going to happen. So the whole food thing, kind of not necessary. You're reanimated by some weird something or other, but I really don't think you need nourishment. But even if you did, why would it need to be human brains? And you know what, Lily? It's not the Halloween show, and I actually meant to call attention to that fact. That I didn't do this as some hokey Halloween gimmick. These are the issues of our time, regardless of the month, ladies and gentlemen. So, okay, but why human brains? And why are they so freaking angry? So, they got reanimated because they got woken up. Dude, I was totally asleep and dead. I was fine here. So now, the only thing I can think of to do to retaliate is to eat your brain. Because what were you thinking? Right? I guess that's it. We need to destroy whatever it was in you that came up with this idea that bringing us to life would be fun. What were you thinking? I know you miss me, but I stink right now, and I'm not going to be that fun to be around. Half my teeth are gone, my jaw doesn't really work, I don't even know how I'm saying this. This is all zombie talk. If you're not, following. Erica! She LOL'd for me, but that was minutes ago. God knows, she could have been laughing at anybody else. And Natty's here, and I didn't mean to miss all of you coming in. But somebody just left. I had to look. See, I had to look just to watch a number drop off. Somebody goes, well, that's about enough. If he doesn't believe in zombies, well, I just can't watch this show. I mean, he seems like a nice guy, and every now and then he makes me grin. But if he's one of these zombie apocalypse isn't happening kind of guys, well, all right, I know what I'm dealing with. But seriously, the whole idea, this premise that if you're reanimated, then their whole mission is to kill living people? Where does that come from? What's the logic? All right. So Natty, now that we're talking about zombies, Natty is feeling great. So now we know a little bit more about Natty. That's just me manipulating the flow of this program, ladies and gentlemen. What if they just went into a grocery store and just started, if they were so hungry, which, again, they're probably not. Anyway, I just don't, see, I'm telling you, as of late, the human brain and psychology is a very interesting thing, isn't it? Just look at this election, will you? Where everybody's looking at each other going, what are you even thinking? How can you possibly, right? Everybody's looking at the other one going, how can your brain even for a moment consider this, right? That's how strong our reality is constructed. And there are people who believe that the zombie apocalypse is coming and that you should prepare for it. That's how malleable our brains are as human beings. That we can actually be manipulated somehow into a state of believing incredibly crazy crap. Why wouldn't we take that amazing brain power and manipulate a reality where everybody's freaking happy and not eating one another? And there's abundance and everybody's doing what they love. And why couldn't we move into a belief system that is that strong? Why does it have to be that, yes, the country's going to hell, everybody's a criminal, and by the way, doesn't matter anyway because we're all going to be eaten by our relatives? Well, I don't know. I guess Chris Stratton, ladies and gentlemen, holy moly, I know he won't stay around. He's a busy guy. He's got stuff to do. Chris, look, I got my own mug. Chris and I have known each other for a long time. I believe he's popped into this show once before. I could be wrong, but I think he did. Chris and I started one of the first web design companies in the world. That's right. You think, Bob, stop. Just will you stop? Fine. I told you, go back to the Wayback Machine, the Wayback Archive, Internet Wayback, look up kudzu.com and go back as far as you can, because we were the first, and you'll see amazing what I thought was cool back then. It is a long time, Chris. And since that time, Chris has become proficient at the banjo, and I have become proficient-ish at the ukulele. There's a lesson in there somewhere, boys and girls. I don't know what it is, but if you look hard enough and you open your heart and you hold a warm puppy close to your face, I think the answers will come to you. Anyway, all right. Yeah. And will the zombies even know who they were? Like, will they really have a vengeance? What is the zombie motivation? Can someone please explain that to me? Because the only thing I can think of is that they're irritated that they were waking up in the first place. Why? Because you missed them? You know, I miss all of my dogs who have passed on like you would not believe. But I wouldn't want them reanimated right now. Now, if they could just come back, you know, how they were in their essence, I'm all on board. How about we believe in that? How about instead of that the undead will come back to eat us because that's what's logical, that, you know, instead let's live with the belief that our pets will just be with us as exactly as long as we are. That seems fair. Labor Day 2007, Chris Stratton said, Labor Day. Oh, is that the last time I saw you? Wow. That is a long time. Is that true? You came out with the banjo, didn't you? No, that's not right, because you came out with the banjo since then, and that started in 2010. You came to my house with your banjo. Or maybe I'm not understanding. I'm sorry, we're having a personal conversation. Could the rest of you just turn your back? I'm kidding, of course. So there, I've said my piece on the zombies. Can we all just snap out of this nonsense? I mean, the worst they would be is an inconvenience. Oh, there's another one. They're not going to come eat you. They might creep you out. But what are they going to do? They don't need jobs because they're freaking undead anyway. I mean, you know, what's going to happen to them? So they're just going to be around. And so then at some point it's going to be like, well, what do we do? Do we kill them again? Or is that even going to work? Or is this just going to be a planet of this, and that's, we just got to learn to coexist? Then someone's going to want to build a zombie wall, obviously. I didn't mention any names. This isn't a political show. Stop. Anyway. I can see, I already, as I was thinking about talking about this, I could see in the future, and I'm telling you guys at Wirecast, you've got to come up with a transition that does the whole dream sequence thing. You got pans and wipes and fades, all very professional, but we need that. I do, because there are times when I just simply have to travel in time. And I need an effect to do that, so let's get on that, shall we? You're right, zombies can climb the wall, because somehow their muscles work. What? Ugh, people, really?
Oh no, you see, because they've been imbued with superhuman strength in the reanimation process.
Why? What is the strength? Is it going into muscles?
Well, no, the muscles have mostly decayed away.
Well, then how are they working?
Well, it's just zombie magic.
See, that's the logic. We can't rely on zombie magic, ladies and gentlemen. We tried it once before. It was a terrific disaster. So much so that most of us have put it out of our minds. You may not even remember it. That's how traumatic it was. Tina Williams is finally here. And it is a party, ladies and gentlemen. It's a Tina Williams party, and she always makes people laugh. That's what we love about her. If I had my piano on right now, I'd play her a little song about how, you know, nothing can go wrong as long as Tina is along. You with me on this? Okay. It writes itself. But anyway, so I've already anticipated the email that I'm going to get. We've introduced you to the character, apparently, just now. And I'm sure it will go something like this.
Mr. Doyle, you are an ignorant idiot. You know nothing about zombies. And it's irresponsible for you to discount the severity.
No, I don't want to use that voice. How about, Mr. Doyle, you are an ignorant idiot. You know nothing about zombies. And it's irresponsible for you to discount the severity and pending likelihood of zombie apocalypse in our lifetime. Perhaps you should do a bit more research than to possible... this guy doesn't know how to write. Perhaps you should do a bit more research than to possibly endanger possibly millions... He used possibly too much. I'm going to rephrase what he says. Perhaps you should do a bit more research than possibly endanger millions of people with your reckless and lame attempts at humor. We'll see how funny you think it is when you're boarding up your windows when the undead are among us. Ha ha, real effing funny. That's pretty much how I see that going. Do zombies use the bathroom? Right, if they do eat your brain, is what's left of them going to use 100% of it? Or will there be waste product? And then what? Zombie poop everywhere? Are you freaking kidding me? And then some enterprising entrepreneur will come up with zombie poop ice cream, zombie poop, whatever. It's just going to be a thing. It's an inconvenience at most. Excuse me, zombies, excuse me. You know, and the smell, I guess we'll just evolve to get used to it. You know, we'll just, our noses over generations after generations, we'll just, you know, it won't be so bad. Zombie depends. With a big letter Z. Depends. That's such a ridiculously inside gamer joke. I don't even play those games. I barely am entitled to say that joke. Unicorns poop ice cream. I've seen that commercial. I've actually seen that commercial for the Potty Squatty. The Squatty Potty. Excuse me. The Squatty Potty. Ladies and gentlemen, if you haven't seen the Squatty Potty commercial, here's what I recommend. First, go see the Poopery commercial, because that's what the Squatty Potty commercial is trying to be. Could be done by the same people. I gotta face facts. You gotta face facts. We all gotta face facts. The Poopery commercials are better. They're just better. I'm sorry. I love the spirit in which you did the ice cream pooping unicorns. But the gal who did the Poopery commercials just is the best. Period. Lynn Rose wants a Squatty Potty. Have you guys seen the Tushy? That's the big thing going around now. It's the bidet. That's right. They're trying to get us to ditch the toilet paper and use a bidet. And they've got a whole campaign around it. And some of it is pretty funny, like visual reactions of people using a bidet for the first time and using the Tushy. And the Tushy is $59 for the regular water one, and there's a warm water version too, which is a little bit more expensive. And it's a bidet that you can put on your own toilet right here in the US of A. Anybody out here from the UK or somewhere where they use bidets? Golden corrals for zombies. God, man, I have an answer for that I absolutely will get thrown off the internet if I say. Oh, but it is so there and completely inappropriate. Oh, it's taking everything I have not to say it. Oh, but I would get in so much trouble. Oh, God, I have to let it go. Okay, never do that to me again. Okay. So anyway, a bidet. I guess you don't knock it till you've tried it. Haven't tried it. So can't knock it. All right, now look. Let me see if there's any other little piece. Oh, yeah, there is one other thing, and then we're going to get into the meat of the thing that's going to be so fun, and I don't know how much time to allow for it. It could die in 3 minutes, which I hope not. I really wanted about three times the number of people in here for this, but instead, we're going to look at it like we're an exclusive group of creatives who had a private mastermind on this instead of a big group community effort, which is what I wanted it to be. So it's just about repackaging it, folks. And then people are going to know, you know what, I just can't afford to miss another Bob Doyle show, because if I can get in on that kind of creativity, it's way more important than my job or feeding my children or any other thing I thought that was better to do at noon on Fridays. One of these days, people will get it. I'm sorry, I'm reading now your comments about zombie poop fertilized lands, Lily. Here is where, here, are you, okay, so first, dang it. See, I told you I need coffee. Speaking of coffee, this is the one thing, I traveled last, you know, I went to Montreal and did Christy Whitman's live stream. If you want more details on that, I do a complete recap on my last Wednesday's Law of Attraction Q&A broadcast. You should go see it. No, not you. You're okay. I'm talking about you. I know you think you know all that stuff already. I'm just telling you. I'm just urging you. There's something there for you. Don't look to your left. I'm talking to you. Anyway, so whenever I travel, I always come back here with some rant about air travel in general. And I do. I have a couple of things, but one of them is just a quick toss away that is really annoying. I have enough trouble falling asleep on planes. I'm one of those people, I can't sleep in cars. If I'm not, you know, if I'm not driving the thing, I can't sleep. So, but whenever I do, if I ever do, in that uncomfortable situation where somehow on a plane I drift off to sleep, every time, my mouth opens and I drool. Every time. Which means I can't sleep on planes. Because I can't be that guy. Because then they're walking up and down the aisle, and then, you know, you see you're already judging everybody. Why give them more ammunition? Look at this cliche. Sitting in the middle like this, mouth open. Ugh. And then there's that moment of awakening, and I'm sorry, with the mustache and the beard, it's even worse, because then it's all just, it's horrible. Now, if I had had a more comfortable seat, perhaps I would have been leaned back, and that wouldn't have happened. Your daughter used to fall asleep on the back of a bike. Well, I hope it wasn't a tandem situation where she was responsible for half the effort. You're from Montreal, Erica? Well, I was just there, and it was beautiful. Man, I'm telling you, we're here in Marina Del Rey, California, known for its mild temperatures year-round and a lovely place to be if you like weather. But this week has been hot. And when I say hot, a lot of you will say, that is not hot, and you would be correct. But when you're not used to it, 90 degrees is hot. When you're used to, you know, lower 80s and that kind of stuff. So it's been, and none of the, you know, these buildings here, they don't, a lot of them, ours included, don't have AC built in because you don't need it. Anyway, Montreal was awesome. 60 degrees. It was like, it reminded me of fall in Atlanta when they used to have a fall. Back in the day. Anyway, it was lovely. So, lucky you, Erica. But, so that's one thing. Sleep, drool, whatever. But, and this isn't just an airline thing, and I know I'm not the only one to freaking talk about this, but every time I have this experience, I go, who are they freaking kidding? Enough already! Enough already! Can you guess what I'm talking about? That's right. The things that the industry, not just the industry, lots of industries, restaurants, hotels, planes, you name it, there's a conspiracy going on. Fast food restaurants. That somehow have decided that a thin, microscopically thin popsicle stick, in essence, or a little plastic rod, a rod that's like an eighth of the diameter of a ballpoint pen, is a coffee stirrer. No, what? Somebody sold this idea to somebody. Oh, that should be fine. Yeah, you just give them a big mug, and they'll pour a bunch of liquid in it. They're going to put 2 teaspoons of sugar in it, and they're going to need to move that sugar around, you know, so it will dissolve in the warm water. Give them this microscopic hair. That'll keep them busy all day. It doesn't matter how long you do it, by the way, and we all know this. What am I kidding here? And the sugar is still at the bottom of the cup when you're done. So, of course, what I do, and I'm sure what many of you do, and if you don't, why wouldn't you? First of all, look for a spoon, right? I mean, if they got a spoon, don't pick up. Don't even. That, it's a spoon. That's the invention. It's been done. We've conquered it. I take like 4 or 5 of those popsicle stick things to have like a paddle, right? We're not saving trees here, ladies and gentlemen. I am systematically depleting the rainforest, stirring coffee, because you won't give me a freaking spoon. Which, by the way, you could wash and use over and over and over again. And don't even start about, well, what if it's to go? They're not going to give away spoons. People give away spoons all the time. Give me a plastic spoon instead of that, this red nonsensical does nothing. And then sometimes you think, well, the little handle on the top, that's thicker than this, so maybe it's supposed to go this way. It doesn't matter. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. Hi, Robert. I hope you didn't cause too much of a commotion when you came in like that, in the back, when I was in the middle of something. You know, it echoes in here. Everyone hears when Robert Hicks comes in late, moving chairs around and whatnot. Now, where was I? Zombies? Was I talking about zombies? No. And so, let's just put a period on the end of this ridiculous coffee sentence. Enough with the powdered creamer. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. You're not fooling anybody. In no way. In no way. Does the flavor that is created by mixing this powder into your coffee even begin to simulate dairy product of any kind? Buttermilk would give a better coffee experience than what we used to call powdered cow hoof. If only a cow were within miles of the facility used to create this stuff, it might be a little bit better experience. But come on. At least give us the little moo cups or the non-dairy liquid. Give me liquid. Powder? I don't need more to dissolve with that nonsensical coffee stirrer. And yet, that's what they do. We've all seen it. You can see it right now. You wake up with your hotel coffee. You go, oh, may as well. Ugh, whatever. And whatever mechanics they use. And then now there's the coffee. It could be the best coffee in the whole wide world. It could be amazing, but then what are your choices? You've got the powdered cream and a coffee stirrer that you can barely see. And so it's just a catastrophe, but we drink it anyway, don't we, boys and girls? Oh, goodness. Anyway, but seriously, it's one of those things that somehow everybody's getting away with. Like, we have become, as a society, so freaking complacent that we accept coffee stirrers like that and coffee creamer like that and say, yeah, that's coffee stirrer, that's coffee creamer. No, it isn't. No, it isn't. No, it isn't. No, it isn't. It's a waste of resources. It makes people go, ugh, ugh. Was that the goal when you invented this? You know, if we put this in bags, maybe one day people will go, ugh. Well, if that was the case, congratulations, you have succeeded in spades. But if anybody sitting at that table, at that committee, sampled this stuff and said, is this whole cream? Is this... You hired the wrong person and you need to revamp your HR department. Dawn, what? Now, Dawn, you're just going to send this whole show in a spiral. Coffee is gross anyway. What? You know how I love coffee. How can you come into my home and say, hey, that thing you love? Gross. What do you think about that?
Well, I just don't... I don't even know what to say. Bruno! Hey, man. If you can get My Coffee Rant on Netflix, that'd be okay with me. Let's get this in front of something. Let's get this show in front of something. I'm going to have to start doing my own propaganda. I'm going to print out my own Entertainment Weekly cover and see if we can't get it to go viral. Yeah, congratulate me. I was the Bob Doyle Show. And then fake, but it'll go viral. And then people come check out the show anyway. What do you think? You love Cody more than coffee. Cody more than coffee. Well, that is true. Cody is my dog, for those of you who are not in the know. Oh. Really? Hi, my daughter's calling me during the show. I'll have to decline that call. And now we're back. That's unfortunate. Now see, I told you, behind the scenes. All right, but look, now we are now getting ready. I wish I had some music that was like, you know, triumphant, here we go, we're about to do something, but I don't. And you know what? I meant the whole time I was talking about zombies, I meant to play scary music. Oh well, maybe next year. I had it right here. Just totally forgot. I got caught so caught up in it that I just said, production value? Forget it. Who cares? Do zombies drink coffee? See, the thing is, I mean, what? They don't have to worry about burning their tongues, that's for sure. Oh, anyway, look. So now we're going to do something. We've got a few of us in here. We've got some creatives. We've got people with smart minds and know how to giggle. So here's what we're going to do. As I said at the beginning, unprecedented. Rob Hicks, nobody on your network is doing this. Nobody. Nobody on Facebook Live has done what I'm about to do. And it's documented right here first. And all of you watching on the replay are going to be pulling your hair out going, I missed it. I had the opportunity to be a part of history, of broadcast history. And what did I do? I had that surgery. Anyway. So today, with your help, and if you don't, you know what, if this whole bit just bombs, I'll just say, well, that's one I thought differently about. I can deal with things bombing. I can. I've got the intestinal fortitude, and I can talk about nothing for a really long time, as evidenced by everything I ever do. Okay. So last week, well, you've met a few friends who I wish I had clips of right now over the past few weeks, who have come in and been characters, if you will. You've met Seymour the Slug. You remember that? The security breach episode? If you don't, you need to go back and watch that, guys. Security breach. That's the title of the show. Where a slug infiltrated the Bob Doyle Studios and started broadcasting on his own accord. Of his own accord. On his own volition? I don't know. Kimberly's here! Okay, Robert. I am going to try with you. I just get so busy with doing this show. Anyway. And then we had the one show where I wasn't myself, and I think it was called I'm Not Feeling Myself or something like that. You can go check out that one if you haven't seen it. And then, of course, 2 weeks ago, we met the lovely and talented Tonto Aphrodite. Also the name of the show. Easy for you to look up. So how do we do all this? How do we bring in these people? Well, I've mentioned it a couple of times, and it's a piece of software, ladies and gentlemen. I know you thought I really somehow knew computer animated beings who just come in here and... But no, you got me. I cheat and I use software. So here's what we're going to do, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to... First of all, I'm not going to start with this one right here. I'm going to just put something else up here. Here's what we're going to do as a group. I want, for this show, now I'm perfectly capable of doing this by myself, but I just thought it would be fun for this particular character that we work on together. I'll have plenty of characters of my own forever and ever. But I thought what would be fun would we create a character together using this technology called FaceRig. And I'm going to show you all these different characters we can choose from. So we're not just going to choose the character. Oh, no, that would be easy and boring. We're going to find out everything about this character. What's their name? Where do they come from? What do they do for a living? What's their motivation? Do they have any quirks? We're going to learn all about this character. And then this character will be a recurring character on our show. And if they're an expert in something, then they're the expert person. Or whatever they are. We don't know yet because we haven't defined it yet. So let me just quickly show you first what I'm talking about for those of you who don't know. Let me just flip on over here. All right, ladies and gentlemen, hi. I am a sample character. Hello, hello, hello. And I am moving as Bob moves, and I am talking as Bob talks. And when he opens his mouth, my mouth opens. I could use a little calibration, but that's okay. Now let's take another look at this. And here's me and that character. All right, so this is what the software looks like. I need to actually recalibrate this real quick. Like, let's do it. Calibrate. Okay, now it should be a little bit better. So now you can see it's kind of mirror imaged, right? So this is, I'm just showing you the basic technology. And then if you see over here, let me move this up so you can see. Now I'm telling you, I told you this was behind the scenes. With this, with these, I can push these little smileys and his face will go like that. His tongue will stick out and I can drag it all around, okay? And of course, raising the hands up, which you've seen me do awkwardly many times when I do this. So now this guy here is just one example of an avatar. So what I thought would be fun is I'll get out of the picture here in just a moment. Let me just have to click some magic buttons. So I will go away. So you'll be able to see. No, that's the opposite of what I wanted to do. That's what I wanted to do. Now I'm going to click over here and you can see. Now we're not going to go through every one of these because that would be insane. But you can see the variety of things that we have. Like last week, we teased this dude here, Jerome Notal. And so once I choose Jerome, boom, he's in my studio, right? Now I can move him around, which I will just do right now. See, I can move him around. I can zoom him up and back. I can, you know, make him look this way and that way. So it's really like I've got a puppet here, right? Isn't this fun? And it all stems from over here because I've just got green screen on. No, they don't have Hillary or Donald. But I could find other ways to do that because I am Mr. Ingenuity. So I think maybe what we should do is we should say, do we want, because we've got animals here, we've got fantastical characters like this right here, like a dragon, which you can't see my face. And probably isn't very practical for being on the set of the Bob Doyle Show. Hello, I'm Daryl, Dragon, you know, from Captain and Tennille. Oh, you probably don't even remember Captain and Tennille. They sang love, love will keep us together. I meant me because I'm Daryl Dragon. All right, anyway, you guys don't know what I'm talking about. Or yes, you do. I know you do. Some of you are old enough to know what the heck I'm talking about. All right, so we've got the fantastical creatures like dragons and things like that. We've got animals, such as like a kitty cat right here. Hello, I'm a kitty cat. I don't know why I talk like the dragon, but what are you going to do? But then there's another cat. So anyway, as you can see, we've got all these. A hamburger. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Hello, welcome to the Bob Doyle Show. I am a hamburger. A very logical choice. Now, if there was pizza in here and Screamin' Sicilian Pizza would sponsor the show, then we'd have all kinds of reason to show food here. All right, so we've got fantastical characters. We've got, I saw what you said there, Don, about dragons pooping a lot. Fantastical characters, we have, you know, men and women of varying, you know, degrees of cartooniness, like this one here. Hello, 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 hello. Now we have to remember that we're creating a character that will be a regular on this show. So we have to be contemplating, is this a usable character? Does this have the potential to be interesting on a recurring basis? So I guess what I'm looking for is, do we want a man? Do we want a woman? Do we want a monster? Do we want an animal? That kind of thing. This guy right here, I'd really like him to be a recurring character because, first of all, he creeps me out personally. Right? I mean, look, let's get him moved over here. Move back. Hello. I'm Carl. Carl the Clown. I love my job. It's the best job I ever had. And when I was asked to, host this show, I thought, well, great. I don't know how to host a show. I'm just a freaking clown. Oh, but you see here, I didn't move this out of the screen. Well, actually, I meant to do that, you know, so you could see behind the scenes. I click here and the thing goes up. So, you know, Carl the clown, he's going to show up. It doesn't end up being Carl. All right, so anyway, and then we've got turkey. So for Thanksgiving, look, I won't go through all of these, but there's Seymour. You remember Seymour. Let's bring him back just for good time's sake. Wait a minute, let's move all this crap.
Oh, it's so great to be back in the studio. I can't remember how I talked. It wasn't like this.
So anyway, but it's nice to have Seymour back in the studio. Am I right, ladies and gentlemen, or am I right? I can do a woman's voice, Dawn, but it helps if I use software to enhance it more so it doesn't sound so much like when Tonto Aphrodite last week. Or 2 weeks ago. You heard Tonto, didn't you? All right, so we've got that. And they also have, this is the entire cast of Team Fortress 2, for those of you who played that game. And then they also have something called Live 2D. So it takes like two-dimensional pictures and does kind of the same thing. So instead, this dude here could be hosting the show, except that he's got his Live 2D logo, you know, taken over. And it's not really it just doesn't seem as interesting to me. And when you click the hands, they don't go up. So let's stick with 3D characters, shall we? But look, just because I said no to a woman's voice doesn't mean that women are out of the picture. They can all be done. So do we want a man? Do we want a woman? And then ladies and gentlemen, we need to make this decision. The show ends in 4 minutes. It's clearly not going to end in 4 minutes. I'm not going to let it end in 4 minutes. We're going to at least choose. Maybe we should, hold on, maybe we should do it this way. Maybe we should let you give it some thought. Maybe over the course of this week, you give this some thought. How about that? Because it's clearly going to take a lot longer than I anticipated to go through this. So now you know the general concept. Whether you're watching this on a replay or whether you're watching this live, Don, Jeff, Erica, Robert, Don, Jeff, Robert, Kimberly, if Kimberly's still here. Kimberly hasn't said hello yet. Kimberly is an old dear friend of mine. She's not old. You know what I mean. Put it up in the fan arena. Don, you rock. What fan arena, you may ask? Those of you who don't know what the fan arena is, well, I think I should show you. So let's figure out how to do that. The fan arena, ladies and gentlemen, is not here. Oh, wait, before we do that, ladies and gentlemen, please, 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 please go subscribe to the podcast, the Bob Doyle Show podcast. It's audio only, but still so fun. It's something that you can have on the run. Did you see what I did there? Look, I made it easy for you. bobdoyleshow.com/podcast will take you to this page. Look, I'm on iTunes. How official is that, Jeff? Nice to have you here. Thanks for hanging in there. Okay, so you want to go and subscribe to the Bob Doyle Show podcast, because then these extra shows that happen between these Friday shows are at your disposal. They're audio only. You can listen to them right in your ear, ladies and gentlemen. It's amazing. It's truly amazing. I record them whenever I want. And then they magically appear, and they're live too, by the way. If you would go over here and, if you would subscribe to my podcast, all you have to do is listen to one when I post it on the timeline. Click through, you're going to go to the page where it is, you can follow me, and then when I go on live, you'll get a notification. How simple is that? You're all going, what did he just say? Look, just go to bobdoyleshow.com/podcast and follow some clicks or whatever, and catch up on your Bob Doyle Show podcast. They go back as far as 2014. 2014? Bob, I thought you just started the show this year. That's just what I expected you to think. All right, so here's what we're going to do. The Fan Arena. I'm going to go there right now so you can see. And how do you get there? Bob Doyle Show. First of all, you have to write Bob Doyle correctly. bobdoyleshow.com/fanarena. And what will that do, Bob? Well, it's going to take you to not the Facebook page that's about to show up, because what you're about to see is what you see after you have joined the Fan Arena, which looks a lot like the Facebook page itself, except better. And I'm going to show you as soon as it finishes loading and I continue to talk through it, and you're seeing the admin portal, but it doesn't matter. The whole idea is that this is where the Fan Arena is for those of you who say, you know what, Bob, I'm so on board this Bob Doyle Show train, I can't even believe it. It's not enough enough to listen to the podcast. It's not enough to watch the show. I need more immersion. How can I be a bigger part of this something that is the magical Bob Doyle Show? Well, that's what you do. You go to the Bob Doyle Show fan club arena, you join, and now you have access to all the past episodes of the Bob Doyle Show, all in one place, in this wonderful, nice little tidy, let me get rid of this if I can, being me. All the shows right here in this nice little scrollable thing. Doesn't that look pretty? And then you can scroll down and there's a whole group. There's a private Facebook group that you get content that nobody else does. And then here you can also listen to original music by Bob Doyle. That's me. I'm Bob Doyle. And if you scroll down further, you get a commercial for my voiceover coaching because, hey, gotta pay the bills. Am I right? Am I right? And then the Instagram feed. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Everything you could possibly want and more is right there for you to enjoy in the Bob Doyle Fan Club Arena, where I will post information about the character building or creation or whatever we're going to call it that we're going to do as a community.
It's the Bob Doyle Show.
Kathy, you joined us right at the end of the show. Whoa. It starts at noon Pacific. Well, thanks for coming. Isn't that it for the Bob Doyle Show this week? Join me again next Friday at noon Pacific right here at facebook.com/Bob Doyle Show.